Hi, my name is Riley, and I'm a third-year marine bio major at OIMB.
Hi, my name is Mackenzie. I'm a fourth-year marine bio major at OIMB.
Hi, my name is Jenna Young. I'm a third-year here at OIMB, and my favorite ocean quote is, "Fish are friends, not food."
Hi, my name is Michelle. I'm a third-year marine bio student here at OIMB. I'm an Aries sun with a Virgo.
Hey, my name is Kat. I'm a third-year marine biology student at OIMB, and my spirit animal is that crab Finding Nemo. Just kind of, you know, because like that.
Crab? What crab are you talking about?
Oh, you know, the crab, they're on the pipe, and they need information. So our research was done at South Cove at Cape Arago State Park. There is a small paved trail that we walked down over some driftwood through a beach and onto this rocky shore sort of area along a cliffside called Drake Point. And we studied Zone 3. This rocky shore environment at South Cove has everything from large boulders, rocks, to even cobble, and many tide pools within that. And in and around those tide pools, we found a bunch of different animals, everything from tube worms, chitons, anemones, fish in many cases, sea stars, and all of these marine invertebrates and the algae around them make up a really unique ecosystem.
The cove was divided into five zones with two transect lines running at 30 meters from north to south. 0.5 by 0.5 meter quadrats were placed a meter apart, and each quadrat had 16 points of contact. At each point of contact, we noted the placeholder, and this could include things like algae, invertebrates, and substrate.
NELA.
We also have one person coming in with their phone, taking a photo of each quadrat, and for the photos, we also took little screenshots of the GPS coordinates. And we had someone who was walking around with an umbrella, so for every photo, we blocked out some of the sun to help with the glare. We also did a swath, so for each transect, we had a half meter long stick, and we counted everything within half a meter of each side of the stick that was over 5 centimeters large or certain types of large algaes.
We also did a random UPC quadrat with a 40 meter transect that ran from the low intertidal to the high intertidal. A coin toss and a number generator was used to decide the location of each quadrat, and the coin toss decided whether the quadrats were placed to the left or to the right of the transect. The random number generator determined how many meters from the transect the UPC would be placed. This was able to document the variation of species at every tidal height of the zone.
For the Species Richness and Site Diversity Rally, we were turned loose to do a time search throughout Zone 3 to find as many species as possible. We only recorded species that were not already recorded in the UPC and swath surveys.
So rally all that crap.
I would say the coolest thing that I saw was just a huge variety of starfish and other echinoderms.
So I spent a lot of time at South Cove, too much time, and I found the coolest thing down there amidst all the algae and all the invertebrates we saw were actually the rocks.
Rock.
I'd say the most interesting thing about this experience was just seeing how many chitons we have in the area and the diversity of them. Riley took it upon herself to actually rip apart a decaying chiton with her bare hands, so that was pretty sick. Well, you'd be surprised how easy it is to flood your boots, and Mackenzie managed to do it every single time.
Refuse! I think the most interesting thing about living on the Oregon coast now and doing ecological surveys is just getting absolutely shit on in the rain.
Oh, he's trying to get under your foot. Reality.
Yeah.
Dude, that's our symbol. This is the OIMB symbol.
Somebody pick him up. Jeez.